What's up, everyone, and welcome back to Movie Race.
You can expect a lot from this show, but a dull moment is quite rare in the Carrington household. With a fourth season on its way, we can only look forward to seeing what these characters are up to next. Maybe introduce a new Cristal. Well, anything is possible. Given the drama and the over-the-top moments in the show, there are things that you don't pay attention to while watching it. So, if you want to find out, keep watching, because here are the Dynasty things only adults notice. Number 5. Cristal sleeping with a priest. Since the moment we were introduced to Cristal, fans knew she was going to be the villain in this show. Even though we later found out that the woman we thought was Cristal was actually named Celia, we were all left in shock. But that gave the show the idea to bring in the real Cristal back. Blake definitely had a lot to go through to get over Celia's death, but quickly he and the real Cristal became close and formed a bond that turned romantic. The problem comes afterwards, or to be specific, in season 3, when Cristal is made director of a veterans clinic. In the clinic, she meets Father Collins, who was a chaplain at the hospital. By now, you'd think that this is fine and everything is normal. But all of that changes when Father Collins begins flirting with her. Cristal was already in a bad place with her marriage being on the rocks. She began to fall for him. Although everyone thought nothing would happen because Collins is a priest, people were so wrong, as Cristal and Collins ended up sleeping together. This was so surprising since all Catholic priests have a celibacy vow. This entire relationship and scenes are quite weird and problematic, and to be fair, they would never have happened in real life, no matter how rocky your marriage is or how much someone is flirting with you, and that person being a priest. But since it's a drama show, not many people paid much attention to it. Number 4. Adam tearing his family apart. Throughout the show, Adam has definitely been the most problematic character out there. Even though Dynasty is filled with backstabbing, evil, and deceptive plot twists, we can surely say that most of the time, it is Adam's fault. He is the long-lost firstborn of Blake and Alexis, but when he was young, he was kidnapped and raised by the same unstable woman who took him from his biological family. After finding out who he actually is, he makes his way into the Carrington family and tries hard to be Blake's beloved son. Now, let's dive a bit into why Adam is problematic and dangerous at the same time. We do know that he wants to get his father's approval and love so bad that he will do anything for it. But that results in doing extremely violent things that just make him even worse. From prescribing fake prescriptions to his adoptive mother and eventually killing her, to driving Stephen insane and locking him into a psychiatric facility. And don't even get us started about the things he's done to Alexis, from burning her face to choosing her new face. With his talent of manipulating and creatively sick mind, he managed to find his spot in the Carrington household. In a sick and twisted way, Adam does care for his family, but is driven by jealousy and trauma, and along the way causes damage anywhere he goes. We do believe he only wants to be accepted and loved and to have his dream family, and we'd like to see him grow and improve in the future. Number 3. Fallon and Liam. The award for best couple in the show definitely has to go to Fallon and Liam. This power couple shows the rest how it should be done. From caring and loving each other to allowing them to be who they are, this dream couple has really won a lot of hearts. For some reason, no matter how much people love these two, they don't see the entire growth of both of them when they are together. So let's go back a little bit and explain the entire story of the couple. They first met when Fallon hired Liam to be her husband in order to prevent her marriage to Jeff. Even though their first meeting wasn't magical and special, after a while their connection only grew and became romantic once Liam fell in love with Fallon. Sadly, all of this was one-sided since she rejected Liam in order to pursue her relationship with Michael, but quickly enough she regretted her decision and admitted her feelings to Liam. They have been through a lot in the past seasons and even were kind of on a break when Liam lost all his memories and couldn't remember who Fallon is. But since he got his memories back, the couple is as strong as ever. We finally got to see them get engaged, and we are expecting a huge wedding next season. This couple just grows stronger and stronger, with Fallon being who she is and at the same time being so vulnerable around him, and Liam accepting her and not trying to change her. They truly are the perfect couple. Number 2. Cristal's ugly side. Cristal is definitely one of those characters that you don't know whether to love or hate. She is always portrayed as the villain in the show, but we do get to see a couple of moments where she is vulnerable and looks like she actually cares. It's hard to say who is the worst character on a show where everyone has an ugly side and they do terrible things to each other, but if we had to pick, it would definitely be between Cristal and Adam. Cristal's ugly side truly shows into the seasons, with the actions she does and how she is treating everyone around her. Instead of working on a relationship with her cheating husband Blake, she plotted to kill Alexis and almost ended up killing her brother in the process. You would think almost killing your brother would put an end to everything, but Cristal just kept going. She tried to become a better person, but without any luck. She slept with a priest and blamed everything on Blake for the breakup of their marriage without even thinking about all the things she has done. Besides Adam, she is definitely the next most toxic and manipulative person on the show. Playing with Blake and controlling him to get what she wants is definitely a thing only sick people do. And even though everyone has an ugly side, Cristal definitely stands out from the rest. But let's not get disappointed yet. Who knows? Maybe next season we'll get to see the new and improved Cristal. Fingers crossed. Number 1. Fallon's growth. And the main character of the show, the one that runs the show, Fallon Carrington. The witty, charismatic Fallon makes every situation better and knows how to get away from anything with her witty one-liners. Remember her kidnapping? She is definitely a character that grew as the show did. With every season, we get to see her be more grown up and dealing with things in her own way. Starting off the show, Fallon was shown as this fiery inheritress who did everything to get her father's approval while still looking out for him in every way. Even though she is manipulative, and we have seen some moments where she does some problematic things, she still manages to surprise us each episode. She is definitely a character that knows what she wants and gets it, no matter the cost. She is intelligent and business savvy like her father, with hopes that one day she will make the COO promotion at Carrington Winbrier. But since that plan didn't work back in season 1, Fallon didn't lose hope. She decided to make a name for herself outside of her father. Over 3 seasons on the show, she manages to launch several companies, all of which fail. By simply trying and launching these companies, it shows the character she has and how determined she is to make it out in the world on her own. With her intelligence and witty comments, we do believe she will make it far and finally step out of Blake's shadow. We can't wait to see what will happen with Fallon in the next season. On a related note, we wanted to know, which one of these things have you noticed throughout the show? Let us know in the comments below. If you'd like to see more amazing videos such as this one, make sure to like the video, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you never miss any of them. And as always, thanks for watching, guys!